Hello, hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're in my channel, I'm Akanksha. In this video, oh my god, it's been a while and I sat down to film a video. I'm a little excited, but I'm also excited to try this new product because this new product is known to be a dupe for the Dyson Airwrap and it retails for like half the price. I'm talking about the Pro Touch Air Short Hair Multi Styler. Now I do like my Dyson. I like it especially for the curling part. And this is supposed to work exactly like that. And that's 40,000 and this is 20,000. It is an expensive product, but it is half the price of the Dyson one. So I do really want to see if I like this one better or the Dyson one. I've been having the Dyson for like a very long time. So I know what I like and there are a few things I really don't like about it. So let's see if this also, you know, matches it or it's better or what. Let's get into it. So this is how you get it. You have all the attachments and then this is the machine. I love that color. It's so pretty. The thing I'm most excited to try about this one is the fact that this one actually twists and like goes to the straight thing and then you can twist it back and use it like a normal blow dryer with the blow dryer attachment. Let me show you that.
A few moments later.
So you can just pop this on and you can use this like a normal blow dryer as well, which this one does not have. Okay, this one is so frustrating. I think if I'm traveling with the Dyson, I have to take like a blow dryer altogether if I want to like blow dry straighten my hair. So I really like the fact that this can be used like a blow dryer as well. I have to test it out, but at least the attachment is there where I can use the device in that way. So these are the four other attachments it comes with. This one is for blow drying, this one is for flyaways, and these two are the curl wands. It says plug, twist and play. You can blow dry, volumize, curl, wave and smooth. So I have, you can see my hair is not done. It is like 80% dry. This is when I start like styling my hair. So it has four different buttons. This is the on and off button. This has a temperature setting so you can increase your temperature. This actually has like a digital display right here where you can see how much temperature you're putting on your hair. And then you have a fan speed and this is like for your cold blast. I think I really like the concept that it actually has like a display so I know how much temperature is going on my hair, which this one again does not have. It only has like a hot air feature, like a medium and like full hot and then on and off and the fan. So I think I like the digital side of it, but let's see how it works. My hair is anyways 80% dry like I told you, so I just directly want to go and see if it can straighten, like blow dry my hair with the blow dryer, like a normal blow dryer generally blow dries. Did I just do like a tongue twister? I also should say that this feels very lightweight. It's not a heavy device. So when you're blow drying your hair, it won't be like you're doing like an arm workout. So without that, you can use this like a normal hair dryer. Like, look at that. I think I already like that this one can be used like a normal hair dryer because I love the blow dry effect like I can get with this, like a roller brush and a hair dryer. So this one already, like, I feel like I like it a lot more than the Dyson for this term because this makes my job and my life easier and I can just carry one device everywhere. Wonderful. Like, okay, the blow dryer, this was the one I was like I told you, the most excited to try. I just want to now switch that up. Like I said, press it, release it. To make this straight, you just have to press this button and twist it up. Whew. Now I'm going to go in with like a blow dryer attachment and test this as well. I'm sure this is going to work, and I like this attachment a lot more than I feel like the rounder brush. This one is like much bigger, that's why, because my hair, like I have a lot of volume. The smaller one doesn't work much with me because, you know, even my roller brush you see is like a bigger one in size. So this head is something I think I would like. Okay, it took me a minute to kind of get here, but we are here. It took me like, I had to go over like 4-5 times for it to be this straight. But this one, actually, this part of my hair is a little wet as well compared to the top part. You can see this is a little more wet. So it could, that could also be a reason. It did straighten my hair properly. After this, I do want to like straighten this out a little bit before I go in with the curls, because you can see I have a lot of texture. Smoothening out this part of my hair always helps before I go ahead and start curling it. So I just smoothened it out a little bit. It's not completely dry. Now I want to go ahead, change this attachment and go in with the curler one. Now these ones, again, they come in two barrels, like the older Dyson used to come, the left one and the right one. The current Dyson though has like a single one where you can just twist and like use, which is a little more convenient compared to this. And also one more point is the Dyson comes with multiple attachments as well. So this one only has this one for like a blow dry smoothing option, while the Dyson comes with this rounder brush, and it also comes with two smoothing brushes. One for like a more wavy hair and one for more softer hair, and it comes with the rollers, etc. So it has two more attachments than this one does. Nevertheless, this one is also, I feel like, quite nice. Now I just want to go ahead and curl and see. It takes so much time to style my hair because of the volume. I just stopped curling my hair and straightening my hair lately because it's so time taking. I'm just doing like my CGM most of the time. But when I curl my hair, I feel like I'm my absolute best. So this one has written it. It is like for your right side. It has like R on the wand. It has gotten very hot too quickly. I just switched it on and it's gotten so hot already. That Dyson doesn't get this hot. This, I feel like, are more metallic plates and these feel more plasticky. So this has gotten like hot. So the right one is not for the right, actually. The left one is for the right. Okay, that wrapped very quickly. Okay, I gave hot for 5 seconds and cold for 5 seconds and ta-da! Oh my god, it's been a while I styled my hair. I love that. Like, the curl is perfect. It's very nice, very smooth. It really took me like 5 seconds, which is amazing. That is super pretty. I'm just going to finish the rest of my hair. Both sides of my hair is done. I put this one at 120 degrees Celsius with the maximum fan. And this actually did, like I told you, it does get hot a lot more than the Dyson one does. The Dyson one operates at 150 degrees Celsius. This one operates at 120 max. But this one does get a little hotter than one, even to touch and feel. So just be a little mindful of that. But it did curl my hair pretty quickly and pretty fast. So I'm okay with it. Okay, that took a while, but oh my god, look at this curl. curls, you guys. I love it. This is exactly like how I get with the Dyson as well. And I just absolutely love these curls. I generally don't open these curls, at least for like half an hour, 45 minutes, so that they're nicely set. And once I open them, they're kind of nice and wavy, because I literally just finished the front section. And if I open it, it'll literally open off. But I'm just going to comb and show you that it can actually like look this pretty. Like once the curls are open, it looks like nice and wavy. That's the look I like. I of course don't like it to be extremely coiled. Like look at that. Oh my god, like good hair makes me much more happy than makeup. Like I said what I said, good hair any day. Without makeup also I can manage, but bad hair day I cannot take it. But I've not, like I told you, curled my hair in a while, guys. And especially in this red hair era, I am like loving this curls. Now, you can see I do have flyaways, and it's time to try the last attachment, which is the flyaway attachment. Okay, a lot of heat. You should reduce the heat definitely for this. So you have three different settings for this. One is the center, you turn it left and then you turn it right. So you can use whichever side you want accordingly. First, I'm going to go for the left one. Okay, that tamed them a little bit. I have to apply a little bit of serum, etc., because my hair generally is on a little frizzy, wavier side. Okay, this is the finished hair, and the room did get a little smoky there with my heat protectant and all, but I love this device, you guys. It actually like works more or less just like the Dyson. Actually, like the two attachments, it comes with a lot more, because this makes it very like versatile. I can use this like a normal hair dryer as well while twisting it. I think I like that factor a lot more. When especially when I'm traveling, I can travel with just like one device rather than having like two on hand. And of course I like this brush a lot better than like a rounder brush, because my hair is a lot more voluminous. This gets the job done a lot more quicker as well. And coming to the curl part, I think both you know, work really great. This one I feel like just does like the job quicker a little bit compared to the Dyson, but overall I love the finish. If you've always wanted a Dyson Airwrap but 40,000 was a really high price point for you, then this one literally comes for half of it, and I definitely think it works really well. So if you're interested, then I'll leave a link for it in the description. You guys can check it out. And yeah, that's about it for this video, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. I hope it was useful. Let me know what other videos you guys want to see from my side, and I will do it for you. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.